Morning, guys. A rainy day up in the mountains today. And typically, I bought no rain gear. Should have done, really, but usually it's such nice weather that we don't have to. So just up at a harvest today. I'm not going to do the full harvest on the video. I'll do some clips of it and then do something else later on in the day. This is the Showa Harvest Nisai, 50 pieces. Currently we have Marusato taking the lines, the cover lines, like the fishing wire for like what you use in England for herons and stuff like that. So just getting rid of all that. In the ponds you've got Kosuke and Kensuke that are just doing it now. Should be quite straightforward. But when in Japan and it's raining and you've got no rain gear, unfortunately you're gonna have to start looking like an idiot. Job done. The atmosphere now is just anticipation. Just give you a little bit of a better understanding on how they drain these ponds. Behind me there you can see stage drains, twist off top caps, so every day they'll just come round, or every day they'll take two off and just let the water just slowly drain away. And that's how easy it is. It's quite good really how they do it. They're just about to start in there. Good today, no koi lost in the pond, no koi jumped out. So it looks like a one net job. Let me spin it around and we'll get close in.
Because you had lots of practice yesterday. Okay.
Got Mr. Gardener on the lift today.
Remember, what is it, Tim?
Don't drop.
No. Cradle, don't hold.
Yeah. Just chuck them in, Matt.
Just chuck them in, sorry.
Some lovely looking shower today. Oh. Yeah. Pictures later. The kids' paddling pool method still widely used by all the breeders in Japan. If it's simple, use it. I'd say as well, when I'm down here, these are down in, we're down in Mushigami. The pond's close to the house. Well, it's a beautiful area if you have a look. many ponds. You don't really normally see this area unless you are actually on a harvest. You can see a couple there just been waiting to be done down there. One behind. One all the way back over there. This area is just full of mud ponds, so belonging to many different breeders. There's no, you know, and there's never any worry that something will happen to somebody's mud pond or anything like that. It's all perfectly harmonious, which is great. But yeah, this place is, there's a few fry ponds down here as well, so it is quite busy year round. But you can still see most of the fish down there that are waiting to come out. Should be good, still many koi to come out of the mud ponds, so this weekend the breeder should be a lot fuller, so which we'll find out this afternoon. Seatbelts required.
No heads! So you tell people Shintaro is so posh.
Yeah.
He has his own bridge.
Our own bridge.
His own bridge and his own road.
Time on the last harvest, quite simple. We were finished, all the fish were done by 10:30, so there was another pond which is just Showa, just close by to the facility again, so they decided to come and do this as well, considering I'm looking for quite a lot of Showa for orders and stuff like that. It's good to get some picture. I pictured some of the ones that we got on the first pond earlier. They were fantastic, some beautiful Showa in there. Also a lovely Tansho Sankey, which I'll probably be posting up. So yeah, we're gonna see how these come out. They do look good. I'll spin it round again in a minute for you. Quite an easy pond to pull, this. I'll give it a quick spin round. They've been in these ponds for quite a long time now, so they spook quite easily. They're just not used to any interaction at the moment, which will change.
No problem.
No problem. I have my young sons. They will run hard.
Mm. Really, 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 really not. Oh, same start again.
Yeah.
Cut again. Cut.
Take two.
Just called into Maruhiro Koi Farm, the younger Hirasawa brother. He bought a facility which was used to belong to an amateur, but he's bought it now and made it into Maruhiro Koi Farm. He's very famous for his big round pond, which is behind me. A lot of people, when they come to Japan, they come for Kahaku, Sanki, Showa, show fish to get the big awards at the koi shows. But these here at Maruhiro, he has individual examples of some amazing, and I mean amazing, Nongo Sanki. I've just seen now a Benigoi, which I'm going to show you, which is probably the best Benigoi I've ever seen in my life. It really is that good. I don't think there possibly could be a better Benigoi. And when you see these huge fish, all perfect examples, you can really appreciate how good they are and how they match up to any Gosanki, really, because they are perfect examples. There's a Ginrin Kimatsuba in here, which I know he's been offered a lot of money for, and he doesn't want to sell it. He has got some, and I don't think they're all in here either. I mean, I'll pan it around in a minute and we can have a look, but I know he's got more than this to come in. But what I'll do is I'll just flip it round now so you can have a bit of a look at some of the stuff in here.
Now you're looking at probably the smallest koi in here, round about 60 cms. The biggest one in here is well over 90. You see the big chago there, that's probably at least, it's got to be over 85 anyway. You'll see some of these koi over 84. Measure out 90 cm, and then you'll see, and look at the girth on her as well, she's huge. It really is, look at the Shisui Maritime. You won't see another one like it. No blemishes, no black spots, perfect. What I'll do is I'll make sure we come back again when everything is out, and we'll get some more good shots when this pond's full.